I just really wanted to make this because if you're in the position of wanting to try something new and you've also gone through something like me where you didn't focus on food and then you were really food focused and you just want to like live your life and be healthy and fit, I want to help you. Hey guys, thanks so much for tuning to my channel. My name is Teresa Campbell and I do all things food, fashion, and fitness. I have a clothing company and it's called Shark's Bites of Life. My nickname is Shark. So definitely check that out if you're interested in some cute gear that I wear. I wanted to pop on here and just kind of do a little overview of my current lifestyle. So I went plant-based starting last year, it was July of 2020. Basically, when we started, it was just to like give it a try. We just wanted to see what it was like. My husband actually had the idea. He was like, let's go plant-based for 2 weeks. Let's see what happens. We'll just kind of see how we feel. And I was like, okay, I'm down with that. Like, I love trying new things. I think that in order to understand a type of diet, way of eating, way of life, you have to experience it firsthand. We started it, we both did it, and 10 months later, here I am. I'm still plant-based. I would say vegan. I don't like to really label myself, but I am eating vegan. So we'll just say that for purposes of this video, so you know what I'm eating. I wanted to share just a few things that I noticed when I started going vegan with my mindset around food mostly. So my background history, I did a bikini competition in 2016. I dieted down quite fast. I was a very healthy, normal body weight. I started there and then I cut quite a bit of weight in 10 weeks with diet and exercise. And during that time, I was eating meat. So I would eat typical meals, you know, just trying to make it as small of calories to get as much food as you can. That is when I first started counting calories. And my mindset around food was always fine. I never really labeled foods bad or good. I did do things like I was keto for a while, and my husband and I, he's in the fitness industry, so we learn a lot about nutrition and fitness throughout the years. So we've done a lot of different things. So we have, like, I feel like I've done almost every type of diet that you can think of. The only one I didn't do is pescatarian. I just wanted to give you a little bit of a background of where I come from, what I've done, what I've tried. And it wasn't to like always just lose weight. It was just to try a new way of life. It was just to like see what it was like, see how I'd feel, all sorts of things. I already know that I have like a dairy intolerance for especially milk. I haven't had milk since like 2008 maybe. When I was a kid, I used to get the worst stomach aches and I had no idea what it was. I would just like curl up into a little ball, be like, I'll be good. Just give me like 30 minutes. I just have to be in pain for a little bit. And it would happen so often that it was just normal to me to have that experience. When almond milk came out, I just realized like, oh my gosh, my stomach aches went away. And it was seriously, it was milk. And it's just crazy. Like what you know now and the past 10, 15 years. Just thought I'd share that so you kind of have like an idea of the where I've come from. So let's fast forward again. We're doing the bikini competition, dieted down, got really lean, knew that wasn't maintainable. So obviously I did the reverse dieting. I have nothing bad to say. Like I had a good experience during the bikini competition. I had a really great coach reverse me out so I wouldn't put on a bunch of weight. I would slowly reverse out. However, once I was done reversing, 2016, and we just got our first house. We had a pool. We're like party, party, party. So we always had like friends over. So we'd eat pizza quite a bit or like just go out to eat a lot. I'd drink a little bit more. I went above my normal set point, which is kind of normal when you diet. It was really, really, really hard for me to lose any weight after that. I had to track calories. I felt like I didn't realize it, but my husband kind of pointed it out to me. He's like, you're really focused on food. I was really focused on like what I was eating throughout the reversing my dieting. I also put on fat. I was lifting a lot heavier, and in my head, I still like wanted to get down just to where I was before the bikini competition. I just want to kind of give you that overall thought. So now I'm more focused on food. Post bikini show, I'm more focused on food. I still have a very good self-image. I love the way I look. I mean, I'm always trying to improve myself. So yeah, I would always still go to the gym. Like I'm very diligent on going to the gym, working out, eating well, but I was still eating meat. I would sometimes cut out dairy, sometimes have dairy because I would love cream in my coffees. God, I just love cold brew with cream, but not great for me. Body did not love that. I would get stomach aches. And then I decided I want to be an American Ninja Warrior. Changed my training, a lot of upper body stuff, a lot of compound movements to be able to hold myself up, have good grip strength and all that. And I was working with a trainer. We were also in the process of moving. So we were moving from Georgia back to Arizona. I followed the program. I was getting really, really strong. I was able to do more pull-ups than I've ever been able to do in my life. Like my body composition just started changing. I felt really good. But I wasn't eating what I would say is a healthy diet. I was eating like I'd go and I'd cook and I'd literally eat like 4 hamburger patties. But you know, if you're eating that much fat, you can't eat a ton of carbs with it. So I wasn't eating a lot of vegetables. I wasn't eating much. And I was always just trying to like, you know, I was always very cautious and like careful with like what I was eating, how much I was eating of it. I was still very food focused, okay? Fast forward, gyms closed down. All of my workouts turned into like indoor workouts. I'd go to the garage if I could last because it was Arizona summer and it was just so hot and dying. So I would do what I could outside, but most of my workouts were inside, meaning not much weight, less motivated. It was difficult on all of us, let's be real. A lot of stress happening. So I really turned inward to cope and like keep myself occupied and busy. You know, my body's put on a little weight. I was bloated so much. And I know stress really bloats me. You know, we were also eating dairy. Wasn't having a ton of vegetables. We've always eaten pretty what I always thought was healthy, but we never really like ate a ton of veggies. We were usually grabbing meat. We were always like heavy, heavy, heavy on the protein. I'd be like, bananas are too high in sugar type of thing. That's how we were. When Nick had the brilliant idea to go plant-based, I can't even describe. It was almost easier for me to just go plant-based. Honestly, I hate cooking meat anyways. I would always wear gloves. I don't like touching raw meat. Just like, man, this is gonna be a great change. Like, I'm gonna eat so many different foods. I was looking at this like, wow, I'm gonna eat lots of different foods. I'm going to experiment, see what it's like, see what happens. I documented my weight, I documented my body composition, I documented how I was feeling in my journal. My life quality improved. Everything got better. My bloat went away in like 2 weeks. I lost inflammation and feeling good, and I felt good because I was helping the planet. I didn't second guess if I was eating something. I just kept within the parameters of, is this vegan, you know? There's so many alternatives out there. I love cookies. So I was able to find like plant-based cookies. Granted, I don't have those often, but another thing was when I was eating the meals that I was cooking, I was getting so satiated from all the fiber and the different types of nutrients. It's like my body was just craving nutrients this whole time and I just wasn't giving it what it wanted. And that's why I was always so hungry or so like having cravings for cookies all the time. I was always like craving sweets throughout the years. I would always want something sweet. And I still want something sweet, but it's like fruit. And the occasional cookies are like ice cream, but it's all vegan. I don't count calories. I am at a weight that I'm very happy with. I don't focus on food. I enjoy making really good meals. I feel like going vegan has created so much freedom in my brain from not having to think about everything that I'm eating. I did have to overcome the idea of what are people gonna think. I used to have a preconceived notion of veganism and like I never thought that they could be athletes. That's when I also went to YouTube. I turned to YouTube and I started Googling and researching and I found Nemai and naturally Steph. Like I just found people that are vegans and they look great. I mean, I work hard, I work out. I just wanted to see other people that had the life and the look and the lifestyle like I strive for because I can relate to that. And they were also vegan. I really think that if you are someone who's been thinking about it, you should give it a try. My husband started doing mostly vegan as well. He very rarely has meat, if once a day. He would really like to not do it at all, but he's working on it slowly, so. Yeah, I just wanted to share this. I hope that I didn't ramble too much. I'm not used to doing these talking videos, but I would like to share. This is just one aspect that I wanna share. I'm gonna just start a series. I'll still have coffee videos, I'll still have fashion videos, but I'm gonna try and like loop these talking videos in once in a while too, because I just really wanna let people know in case they're like me and they're looking for answers on how you feel, how you look, pros and cons, and all that stuff. So. Thanks so much for watching. Please like and subscribe. It really helps me out. Leave me a comment if you like this form of video. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.